Bartie, and welcome to the Captain's Vlog.
Don't beat the drums that frighten the children. Don't sing the songs about winning or losing. Sit down beside me, the green fields are bleeding. Sing me the music of healing.
Okay. Here we are on the Captain's Blog again with Gilly Hewitt. We've got here some with us today. Gilly, you're going to tell us a bit about your music, especially, I think, your past and about your association with Burns, Robert Burns, my favourite poet.
Yes, we grew up, I grew up, spent most of my teenage years in Alloway, around that area. So we grew up with Robert Burns. My father moved around a lot in his job, so... we were born in Glasgow, lived in Edinburgh, lived in Ayr, but we were there for 8 years when I was 10 till I was 18. So we learned all the Robert Burns at school, but when I got into folk music, I don't quite sing it in the same drawing room manner that we learned it at school. But I used to sing round the piano with my mum. She played the piano.
Right.
And Robert Burns things were songs we sang and used to harmonise with her.
Sing me the songs of a lover returning. The darker the night, the nearer the morning. Bring me the hopes of a new day that's dawning. Sing me the music of healing. Stronger than the guns of thunder, even when we're torn asunder, love will come again.
Yeah, and how did you get into folk music? Was it in Edinburgh or Glasgow?
Well, my brother Alan, when I was a teenager, he wanted to get a guitar. And when I heard he was getting a guitar for Christmas, I wanted a guitar too. But still being at school and studying, I didn't really spend the time that he did on it. And he was working at the time. And he spent every evening in his room learning things like Angie and The House of the Rising Sun. And he quickly got very good. So I was studying for my O grades and highers, and I kind of left it at that time. But I used to go sometimes to the Ayr Folk Club and see people like Barbara Dixon and when I was about 16.
Yeah.
And later when I ended up back in Edinburgh as a single parent, I used to go to Sandybells a lot because my brother was then in Edinburgh as well. And I knew Sandybells from going in there with him.
Sure.
So it was the kind of place I could go and meet friends, and even if I was on my own, I could go there on a Friday night, know I'd meet people I knew and hear some good music.
Yeah.
And through that, I met my husband,
through
going to a party after Sandybells. And he took me to the Edinburgh University Folk Song Society. And in those days, it was the Crown Folk Club as well. And I quickly got really involved in that.
Yeah.
In those days, folk song, as well as nowadays, it's great to see the students nowadays being so enthusiastic and coming in here and performing. But back then in the late 70s and early 80s, we used to have a concert every second Friday, big artists. So one Friday we'd have a concert and the next Friday we'd have a sing-around in the Talbooth Tavern.
Excellent.
And the Tuesday nights we had workshops. We had singing in one room, guitars in another, fiddles in another, whistles in another. And on the Friday night, it was the concert night. And I was the treasurer, sat at the door taking the money, and my husband, he booked all the artists.
Yeah.
So that was where I got started off singing, because we used to go to the Talbooth Tavern and Ian said, you should sing something. So I learned a song.
Yeah.
And then, of course, being really at home in down in Drummond Street there in Lady Glenorchy's Kirk Halls was where the club was on a Friday night, and I started off doing floor spots and times the truth is like a hare in the cornfield. You know that it's there, but you can't put your arms round it. All you can hope is to follow its footprints. Sing me the music of healing. Who would have thought I could feel so contented to learn I was wrong after all of my ramblings? I've learned to be strong and I've learned how to tremble. Sing me the music of healing. Stronger than the guns of thunder, even when we're torn asunder, love will come again.
Sandy Bell's Hamish Henderson would be about in those days.
Oh, yeah. He certainly was, yeah, yeah. And then I got involved with playing in the Royal Oak. And I used to play with a singer, songwriter, and guitarist, David Potter, who now lives in Stonehaven. And we used to do an evening together in the Royal Oak. And then they asked us, would we do different nights? So I had to learn an instrument then, because I couldn't do the whole night as a sing around if I didn't have an instrument.
Indeed, yeah.
And the banjo.
The banjo started. Yeah, you play it really well. It's very distinctive. I really like the sound. I always know you're in when I can open the door and I hear the
Well,
banjo.
The banjo is different. And partly both my brothers play guitars and write songs. Yeah. So it's a wee bit different to play the banjo. But everybody's got their own style.
Yeah.
And I kind of developed my own way of picking and frailing. But I learned it from... To begin with, from my friend Noel Rocks, who at that time was playing professionally, and he would been talking about banjos, and I expressed an interest in learning banjo. And he said, well, if you ever get one, I will, as a friend, I'll give you lessons. And Christmas, my husband bought me one.
Wow.
That's how it started.
Yeah. I don't know why I sort of associate the banjo with America, but I mean, yeah. Origin.
Well, it probably is really a very American instrument, but you know, obviously in the south of Ireland, you get a lot. The tenor banjo is quite a big instrument there.
Yeah.
But yeah, you get banjos all over.
Good, excellent. And the songs you sang, do you want to tell us something about them?
The story
behind them.
I sang a song called "The Music of Healing," which is written by Tommy Sands, and he lives in Rostrevor on the border between the north and the south of Ireland.
Yeah.
And his whole family play music and sing. And it's a song to me that I feel is really important, with my father coming from the north of Ireland.
Yeah.
And I've got lots of family over there. And we used to spend a month every summer with my granny when I was growing up. So peace in Ireland means a lot to me.
Oh,
and that's what... That the song is about, really. But it can be the music of healing anywhere.
Yeah.
Trouble in the world anywhere.
Yeah.
It's relevant.
But I can hear it's really yours. You're very passionate about it.
The second verse, actually, Tommy wrote it, and he had two verses. And he played it to his friend Pete Seeger, who said he needed another verse.
Wow.
So Pete Seeger wrote the middle verse.
Really?
And I love the middle verse, because the words are just... Sometimes the truth is like a hare in the cornfield. You know that it's there, but you can't put your arms around it. And I love that line.
What a metaphor. Yeah, that's fabulous. Excellent. Okay, and so if people want to come and hear you singing, do you come on special nights or special days?
Well, I do often come in on a Tuesday when my brother Alan Johnston is running the session in the afternoon.
Right.
And if he's away on a trip with his camper van, I often run the Tuesday afternoons. And I regularly do the fourth Saturday of the month. And anyone's welcome to come in and join me and play in the session on a Saturday afternoon, 3:30 till 7. I also often play in the Dalriada in Portobello on a Sunday afternoon.
Down at the beach, isn't it?
Yeah, it's great. You sit in the bay window and the beach is just through the window.
Excellent.
And it's a fun session on a Sunday afternoon.
Good stuff. Okay, thank you very much. That was great.
Thank you.
Is there for honest poverty that hangs its heat and all that? A coward slave, we pass him by. We dare be poor for all that. For all that and all that, our toils obscure and all that. The rank is but the guinea stamp, the man's the gout for all that. What though on hamely fare we dine, we're hodden grey and all that. Gay fools their silk and knaves their wine, a man's a man for all that. For all that and all that, the tinsel show and all that. An honest man, though earthy poor, is king o' men for all that. Ye see yon birkie called a lord, wha struts and stares and all that. Though honours worship at his word, he's but a coof for all that. For all that and all that, the ribbon star and all that. A man o' independent mind, he looks and laughs at all that. A prince can mak a belted knicht, a Marcus Duke and all that. But an honest man is a boon his micht, good faith ye mona for that. For all that and all that, their dignities and all that. That pith o' sense and pride o' worth are higher rank than all that. Let us pray that come it may, and come it will for all that. That sense and worth through all the earth shall bear the grief for all that. For all that and all that, it's coming yet for all that. That man to man the world o'er shall brothers be for all that.